Yeah, once again, very warm welcome all of you to the Department of Industrial Management, University of Catalonia. You all know, this department is located in the Faculty of Science, University of Catalonia. Very warm welcome. You will be with us in another 1.5 years. So let me quickly go through some basic introduction to the program. If we have some time, we will have a quick get to know session as well. Okay, so as I mentioned, even at the inauguration, you have achieved something during this pandemic time period. People are kind of frustrated and going through a lot of difficulties, and they can't even manage their day-to-day activities. But you have gone beyond that, and you have applied for a new programs, and you have successfully entered for that programs. That means it's really great that you have done something, right? You can be proud about it, because the reason is with this pandemic, people are struggling a lot, and with that even we have to see how we can move forward. With this new normal, you all have made it, and then congratulations and welcome to our family. These are in our department. I think hopefully within this time period, you will be able to physically visit the department and get this experience. Okay, as we have already discussed who we are, I think we are trying, and some of you may have already visited the department and some may not. But you know, our university, I think this board you may have seen if you are, when you are passing the Candy Road. And this is our department. This is also visible to the road. You may have seen it's a playground, but the front side is not visible to the Candy Road, but when you are coming from the Tiruvankura side, you might be able to see. This is our building, one building, and then we have another building now, 8-story building. So this is our physical building in the University of Catalonia. I expect you to be able to come and enjoy the university life, I know, for the second time as well. As Dean and our head of the department mentioned, we have our department was established in 1901, right? That is at this time of establishing the Faculty of Science. Now you can see it's around 54 years ago. The purpose is to teach management to science students. That's how it has been established at the beginning. And then, but it's not the traditional management like the commerce, that's a but it's kind of a soft part of the management. You know, whatever the, like when you're going up in the hierarchy, you will have to manage people. So in that case, people who are coming from science background, then your ability, thinking, analytical abilities are anyway there, but you should have some skill to manage people as well. And the people management and the product management and all that, with that objective, initially this department was established. And then in 1995, they have introduced operation research and information technology. From that point, like it's not just management, it's combinations of management and IT. And in 2003, we introduced the management and information technology big programs, which is known as MIT. I think now we will get confused, like we have two abbreviations. As one abbreviation for two different programs. Even your master programs goes as MIT, Master of Information Technology. Our undergraduate, our degree programs was as MIT, which is Management and Information Technology. That was introduced in 2003. And then we have some postgraduate programs introduced at the same time. Masters in MSc in MIT, right? It's not this MIT, Master of Science in Management and Information Technology. And postgraduate diploma in Information Technology. I think you already know this initially, this postgraduate diploma in Information Technology. Now we have converted it to a master program, and you are the third intake, but if you consider the direct intake, you are the first intake, because earlier we got the students to register for postgraduate diploma in IT, and then it was converted to a master. But this time, you people directly joined for this master program. We had postgraduate diploma in industrial and business management, which was introduced in 2003. And in addition to that, I think you all may be knowing, in the universities, the processes by the quality assurance body. And now even there are different quality assurance bodies, but after that we didn't have a formal process, but we have submitted some documents, but still they are in the process of reviewing. Our last review about the quality in the department, that is in 2008, you know, it's more than 10 years ago, but the quality review was done for almost all the department in all Sri Lankan universities. So then based on their evaluations, they gave grades for 8 different criteria. We got A for all the criteria. I think in the University of Kalania, there aren't any other department who got A grades for all the criteria, but University of Moratuwa, there are a couple of department, 2-3 department, they have got A, but in the university system, only very few department got A grades for all the criteria. Just to brief you who we are. I think when you join a new place, you also like to know their history. And then we introduced this, in addition to this BSc MIT, we introduced BSc Software Engineering degree after that. And then from this year, now we have, now in this 2021, in addition to this BSc MIT, we have a BSc IT degree as well. Just for your information, when it comes to our undergraduates, once they complete the 4 years, sometimes some of them are, while they are in the fourth year, while they are getting the employment opportunities. So our employment rate is, I would say, almost 100%. I just put about 95%. There are some students, sometimes one or two, they don't want to do the jobs, and sometimes they are waiting to get some higher study opportunities. Other than that, almost all the students are getting opportunities even before they complete the degree. From this year, now we have, in addition to BSc MIT, we have a BSc Information Technology degree as well. Now we have a Master of Information Technology Master Program. And we introduced another Master Program in this year, Master of Data Analytics. We'll be launching BSc in Industrial System Engineering, and we are going to introduce a doctoral program in Information Technology soon. And as some of the speakers mentioned at the inaugurations, one of the department in the university system who got the ISO 9001 2015 certificate. I think again, there aren't much department who has got ISO 9001 2015 certificate. In University of Kalania, according to my knowledge, there are two departments. One is one department in the management faculty, and in the science faculty, we are the only department who has got this ISO 9000 2015 certificate. Again, this couple of pictures for your reference. This is our old building, the same building that I showed you earlier, and this is our new building. As I mentioned, now we have two buildings. So our strength is the staff members, not just physical facilities. Now you have seen the physical facilities that we have. All these physical facilities we have got through competitive grants. That means the staff has worked to get those grants. That's how we have got those funds, and you can see we have kind of fully fledged equivalent to the foreign university. is physical resources. So all that based on these competitive grants given to the universities based on their, the proposals. So in that case, the staff has worked for that, and that's how they have got those grants. And our strength is our faculty. We have all our staff members are qualified, and I think as you already noticed today, some of them are on study leave in different countries, didn't even join for the today's inauguration. But all our staff members are having postgraduate qualifications from different parts of the world, USA, Australia, Japan, Netherlands, New Zealand, Czech Republic. Just very recently, one of our colleagues went to USA. And yes, I heard while we were having the inauguration, she has got the PCR test done there, and it was okay. And so that's one colleague went. Likewise, we have many in Australia, some one in New Zealand, one in Japan. They didn't join today for the inauguration. Here, this is just a picture we took the day that we got this ISO 9001:2015 certificate. This is just to show some brands, based on some of them, most of them are based on our students' activities. We have expositions, that is the magazines that our students are doing annually, and then we have our students are doing different competitions organized for inter-university children, and then some hackathons are organized for the school kids. I think some of your teachers, you may be knowing this junior hackathon. And in addition to that, we had a couple of sessions with teachers at MIT. These are a couple of brands that we have already created. Again, for you to see some pictures of our building. It's sad, during this time, some of the plants may not be visible as it is because there won't be much people watering and all that, but anyway, time to time we used to go to the department, and anyway, we are functioning all this time virtually. We are functioning, all our programs are running. You are this, as I mentioned, you are the third batch of this, the second batch of MIT. We started virtually, and the was virtual, but they wouldn't have got the chance to visit the department much. Hopefully you people will get the chance to visit the department soon. And since you have not got the chance to visit the department physically, I have included a couple of pictures for your reference, just to get some idea. These are our classrooms. I think now it's not that important in the sense the setup. You can see this was these furnitures we got maybe 20 years ago, even more than that, while we were studying. So you can see at that time when we were having that big screen computers. So at that time this glass was there. We can use this setup for a lab and the normal lecture halls. Otherwise, once you put that screen on the desk, they can't see the front. So therefore, inside this glass, the monitor was there, and the people can see through the glass. You can use this setup for a lab as normal lectures. That's the setup that we have, keyboard and all that can be kept, and there is a place, and that's the setup that we had. You can see these furnitures are still in good condition. These are we will have to show our even our undergraduates, even the postgraduates, they are keeping all these resources carefully. So you can't see anything on the desk or chairs. So even though it is 20 odd years old, but still it looks brand new condition. Again, this is another lecture hall. These furnitures are also old. Yes, as I mentioned, it's again, More than 20 years old. Yeah, I can remember when we were studying. Yes, then it's old furniture, but it's in good condition. And this is our computer lab. This is some work students are doing IoT lab. I think you also will be having the modules and you will get a chance to do those things. We have got all these kits and all, but we need to have the physical setup to do this. And this is again the inside apartment. This is our new department. We had Philip at the new department in 2019. Some of the pictures taken there. So then that's just to give you some idea about the physical resources. Hopefully you all will get the chance to physically visit the department and experience those resources. Okay, now we'll see you all have done formal education, school, undergraduates or the degree level qualifications. You all have acquired the degree level education. That means you have learned and you have been learning and you are willing to learn. That's the reason that you have joined for this program. You are professional. Yes, we know, like we all like know how to like give the due respect. Yes, as professional, like you'll be getting the due respect, but when it comes to learning, yes, we need to learn. Like you have joined here to learn. So we need to get ready to learn. Like we need to remove all the other titles and all that. Now we are coming to this learning mindset, right? But you know, throughout the life, continuous learning will make us better. We should not get restricted to one frame. Then like if you get restricted to one frame, unlearning, sometimes unlearning is also important. Like if you are, so it will be really hard if you have taken something wrong, it will be really hard for you to get it corrected. Therefore, this learning, unlearning, relearning, all are very, very important. Especially when it comes to postgraduate education, so learning, unlearning and relearning is very important. The reason is sometimes if you have learned something in a wrong way, sometimes there can be things, there is no right and wrong, but you can put your opinions. But if the logical, even if you see it is not rational and the way that you have doing it is not correct, then you should be able to understand it, not because of somebody else is telling. And then you should be able to correct yourself. So the knowledge is everywhere. Like you can acquire the knowledge and think. You have the brain and you can think and see how things should be. Like sometimes some of the things are registered in your head. So whether it is correct, like you need to think about it, right? So then you have to get ready to that learning mindset. Don't think, okay, I know everything. We all like are ready to learn, right? We don't know everything. So even as lecturers, even we are ready to learn. We are continuously learning. There are many things that we don't know. So when it comes to like, if you want to really learn, like you need to get ready to that the learning environment and change your mindset for that learning process. Yeah, so then, may I know all of you can understand Sinhala in case if there is anything. Is there anyone, can you raise your hand, those who can't understand Sinhala? Okay, raise your hand those who can understand Sinhala. Rajmohan, you can understand Sinhala, right?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. Are there any other person who can't understand Sinhala? Anyway, the term of instruction is English. We will be doing lectures and everything in English. I just thought if there is anything that I can just use the Sinhala language just to explain anything. But you are the only person, Raj Mohan, you can't understand Sinhala. All the others can understand? Rajmohan, you can't understand Sinhala, like I mean
Yeah, I can understand English, but Singalam I can't understand.
Okay, from which part of Sri Lanka, Rajamohanika?
I am from Vavuniya.
Okay.
Excuse me, miss.
Yeah.
I can't understand Singalam.
Yeah. May I know your name?
Shalini from Vavuniya.
Okay, so you're both. Okay, anyway, don't worry. Like, we'll be using English as a medium of instruction. So, I hope all of you can understand English. At the end of the day, let's say theoretically, our medium of instruction is English. But if you can't understand anything, I mean, today we didn't discuss anything. We are just discussing about the background and all that. But in future, in the class, if there is anything that you can't understand, the hand or voice and express, okay, can you explain it again? And I find it difficult, like if possible, okay, to explain it in another language. Unfortunately, I can't explain it in Tamil. But then, yeah, if there is a requirement for you, for me to explain it in Sinhala, I can do that. But unfortunately, I am not in a position to explain it in Tamil. But if you really, really want some support, we can see sometimes, like, we'll be having some of our temporary staff members who are Tamil. But if you need some individual support for you to understand some theoretical concepts or some practicals or whatever, we can even provide that support. Be open, like the objective is there for us to learn, right? That's the objective. That's the reason that you people have come. Yes, most of you may need to get the certificate. Yes, definitely it's important for you to get the certificates to get your qualifications or get your promotion. Yes, you need to work on that. Then at the same time, just try to acquire the knowledge through that so that you can do better in your profession. Okay. Yeah, so here, okay, what I want to tell is now we all need to come to that learning mindset. You may be the CEO of a company, you may be a principal in a school, you may be the lecturer in a university, but here we do, like, we give the due respect to each one of you, but we all need to, like, come to that learning mindset. Otherwise, you may not be able to get the best out of the program. Hold on, there's a chat message. I'll just check. So then when you are getting ready for this learning process, intellectually curious. So you should not be ready, like, to accept whatever the things people are telling, right? You have to think, okay, why it is working like that? Is it going to work it in this way? Does it make sense, right? Then you will have to be curious. No, otherwise, if you don't have that curiosity, you may not investigate more. Then only, like, okay, let's say I have just put here a couple of pictures of our undergraduates. Okay, I have not, I didn't really get the permission, but it's there in our website as well. But it's one of, these are final year undergraduates. I would say, like, some of these people, like, even once I saw the picture, I remember this person, like, doing really well, like, doing a lot of research, investigations by himself. So then he's performing really well. So the reason is, like, just listening to the lectures, you will be getting very little. You may be knowing, right? Just listening to the lecture, you will be getting very little. But then through that, okay, if you hear something at the lecture, what is it? Like, how it is working? So you should be curious and you need to investigate more and see how, why it is working like that. Is there any other way that you can do? How other people have defined it? So then always, like, you need to be, like, intellectually curious. Then it will help you to, like, enjoy your learning and then explore more as well. And self-driven. Okay. Now, as postgraduate students, definitely you are, like, not like somebody else is not pushing you, like it's self-driven. So you are at the driving seat and you know where you want to go. So then you have the aim and so you are like taking your, then based on that, you are based on your objectives, you will take the turn at the different places and you will take your vehicle. So then you have your own objectives, and then in this learning process even you just try to make sure whether you are getting those objectives. And at the same time you can see how we can make things better for the generation. And good time management, which is very, very important when it comes to postgraduate. I know all of you will be very busy and with your work life and with your family life. And now you need to do this postgraduate studies as well. The time management is important. But again, remember, like when it comes to when you are having multiple work, like thinking about, okay, I'll have to do this, I'll have to do that, that does not help, right? But no point of thinking about it. But if you plan things, it will work, right? But if you are doing something, even if you are thinking of something else, that wastes your time. But definitely it's possible. And other thing is, you need to give due credit to you. You all have successfully completed your bachelor's level education, so professional equivalent educational, the qualification, so that you all are capable. So you need to give due credit to yourself. I can do, right? So sometimes it might take little time. Okay, you should not get discouraged. If there is a new concept or new subjects, totally new to you, sometimes you are coming from different background. So you might feel, oh, it's really hard for me. No, don't think so, because it's something new for you. That's why it might take little time for you to grasp it. But then when you get familiar, you can move forward. But initially you may have to put little effort. But don't sometimes compare yourself with the others. They may have done those subjects in their undergraduates or some other places. That's why they are more comfortable. But if you are going to learn it for the first time, then you can't compare yourself with the other people. But you know, like, okay, you can do in your life so far, then in the same way you can do, but you need to have a very good time management, since you are having your family, you may be having kids, and you may be having some responsibilities in your work environment. So you need to have a good time management. But we have designed our programs even in such a way for you to support, but still your own discipline and the time management will help you to successfully complete the program. Capable of admitting uncertainty. You know, now everything is uncertain with this pandemic, right? So now if everything is certain, like, we have less challenge. Now, according to the current setup, we can't give the exact timetable as well. Earlier we used to give the exact timetable. Okay, we are going to have the lectures from this date to this date, exam will be conducted on this date. Now with the current setup, we can't give that sort of timeline. But still, in the virtual environment for the new normal, we are just trying to adjust and do things. But sometimes unexpected things might happen and we had to do certain alterations accordingly. No point of just waiting and like suffer thinking about it, like that. So we'll have to see how we can adjust to this new normal and move forward. As I can see, you all have already adjusted. That's why you have taken some new step in your life in this new normal situation. So that means you are admitting these uncertainties and moving forward. Continue that. Creative and original. Always when you are like learning, when you are doing things, just try to be creative. Don't just accept things somebody has told you. But you have some intellectual capabilities. You have good source of knowledge by now. You will be getting good source of knowledge. In the internet, there are vast amount of knowledge available. So then you will have to think, okay, is that the only way? Is there any other way? And is there anything that I can do, right? In this pandemic, when people are just trying to see, okay, there are so many new problems. Is there any way that I can contribute and I can find solutions. Sometimes when you are through these master programs, you are getting new knowledge. Through that new knowledge, just see, is there anything I can do to the society? May not be an exact requirement of the degree, but just think it in that way, and then it will help you to learn, and then you will enjoy learning, and you will apply what you learn. Think broadly. Don't just think, let's say if you are doing a programming concept or if you are doing the database concept, don't just limit, okay, I just want this module to pass the pass this module, and then after that I don't care. No, you should think where we can apply those knowledge, how it can be used, and when it comes to problem, even any particular problem in the society, think it broad. Like, let's say sometimes maybe a problem you have faced. Sometimes if you think from my scope, I may not be able to see the problems, the clear picture of it. Now we should be able to think the whole picture. Like one aspect could be what I can see right now, but there can be some other aspect of it. Hmm? Then only you can see a lot of issues are there which has not been properly addressed right now. So as educated people like us, should see how we can give some solution. So now we need to think broadly. Don't think like we just try to make use of what other people are doing, but is there anything that we can do? We should try to do. Solid reading, writing, and analytical skills are important. Now, the new generations, people are very much into technology, and then they watch videos and all that, but still, reading will improve the broader knowledge. Solid reading, writing, and analytical skills are very, very important when it comes to convey what you know is in the written form. You should be having a good writing skills, and if, when you are going to take decisions, you need to have a good analytical skill. Communication skill is very, very important. You all may be knowing. In your organizations, even when you want to communicate with people, capable of performing under pressure, the job, like, there will be the difference, the levels of workload or the pressure coming, but each and every job, you are getting some sort of pressure. It will be different from job, your designation to the other person's designation, but you will have to learn how to work under pressure. So then, you should not think about it, but if you are planning things properly and understanding things, then you should be able to work under pressure. Able to listen and understand others' perspective. That is important, right? Sometimes we may see, like if you are thinking narrowly, we may see only our side, but there can be some other angles, other views people can see. We should learn to listen other people and see the other avenues as well. Okay, so then that mindset is important. Now itself, I know you all know, and you may be doing it, but you'll have to refresh and think, okay, sometimes I may have to relearn. I may have to unlearn. Unlearn in the sense the things which are registered. If that wrong thing is registered, like you may not be able to get some concept, because you are thinking of what is already registered. But just investigate and see, okay, you don't want to accept. Like even your lecturers are telling, even I'm telling, or any other lecturer is telling, you don't want to accept. Just think whether it makes sense. And then what I already think is correct, is it really correct? Like, so you'll have to see, yeah? You'll have to think it in that way. So then you need to create that mindset, and then you need to have, move forward in this learning process, you need to set your own goals. Now definitely as postgraduate students, your goals are by you, right? Yes, right? In the undergraduate, sometimes parents used to set goals for the kids, undergraduate student, but when it comes to postgraduate, I'm sure that you have created your own goals, because you are the person who know your capabilities and what makes you happy. sometimes somebody think, okay, becoming a doctor is the best thing, but if that does not make you happy, you should not try to like set that as your goal. If you think if you want to become a, let's say, just maybe mother, like you want to become a businessman, like you want to become an entrepreneur, so you want to do something that what other people are not doing, so then that make you happy. So then just see where you are good at and what you really want and what make you happy, and then set your goals accordingly. And when you are setting goals, your goals should be moderately challenging. Otherwise, like something that you can easily do, like you can anyway do it, right? In that case, whether you have set the goals or not, like you can just push through without much effort. So when you are setting goals, like you should set goals which are a little challenging as well. And then it should be realistic as well. No, otherwise, like daydreaming, so you should not put goals in that way. And that should be measurable. Otherwise, it's not, okay, I want to do something not very clear. And when do you want that? I want to become somebody one day. But then one day, no idea. Like, so then, if you have a goal, then you need to work for that. Then for that, you need to have a plan. But to get the plan for you, you need to know when do I want to be there. Then that should be measurable. Like, okay, 5 years time, I want to be like this. I want to gain certain knowledge, certain skills. Then, okay, what are the things I'm supposed to do? Okay, I can follow master programs. I can follow some other programs. I can investigate something by myself and do a little bit of research. Then I can achieve whatever the objective that I want to achieve. And then that should be very, very specific as well. Not, you don't want to do a master program since your friend is doing. So then whatever the programs, you need to carefully select which match with your objectives. And that should be very definite as well. And then when you are setting goals, like be positive. No? There are like, we are not perfect, but then there are positives, negatives, some additional constraint will be there. Okay, so always I'm having like a problem with kids and I'm having problem at office, and then like, how can I do it? Don't think negatively, but there are positive side in your life. Many of us, life is anyway full of problems as well, but then don't focus those things. But you need to focus positive side of your life and see how you can make it better. Then if you are focusing positive side of it and trying to make it better, your negative part is getting reduced. Otherwise, if you are just focusing the negative part, like negative part is getting increased. Okay, so that just to like remind you, like you need to have that mindset which will help you to become successful in this learning process. What is your programs? Now you all have joined for this Master of Information Technology. In this program, you can see here this MIT programs, which consists of machine learning, big data analytics, and you have database administrations, programming, web development, UI UX design, all that is there. Okay, so then, but always I hope like you have selected the programs which matches your objectives as well. When it comes to objectives, you have your own objectives which make you happy, and in addition to that, your career objectives which will help you to become successful or move to the next level. Okay, here this your program's called as Master of Information Technology, and this is a conversion IT degree. I hope you all are clear about it. Are you clear about it? This is a conversion IT degree. That means even this is mainly focusing the non-IT people. That's why we call conversion IT degree. But the non-IT people who are going to excel in the IT field or who are going to move to the IT field, sometimes some people who may be having little background about the IT, but still they want to have a formal education in the IT process. And then some people may be having some IT knowledge, but they want to refresh. But it's kind of a conversion IT degree. This degree, this master program comes under SLTF level 9. I hope you have heard those things. Any one of you can say what is SLTF stand for? You can put the message in the chat or you can unmute and talk. What is SLTF stand for? In the class, of course, we need to be interactive. Huh? Then today I didn't ask much questions, like as you people are professionals and you can share knowledge, and otherwise it will be like very dull. And so then we need to be interactive. Sri Lanka qualification framework. Yes, Christina, thanks. Yes. Oh, yes, you all know. Okay. According to the Sri Lanka qualification framework, this master program comes under level 9. I think you may be knowing if your bachelor's degree, generally that comes under level 5. If you are having a bachelor's degree, that comes under level 5. If you are having the special bachelor's degree, which comes under level 6. And the postgraduate certificates come under level 7, and postgraduate diploma comes under level 8. This is master program, this sort of master programs comes under level 9. So now you know what sort of qualification that you are going to get. That is SLQF level 9. And these programs will help you to empower. If you are an IT teacher, you can excel in that field, and if you are an instructor, then that empower you to do your task better, and for industry professional even that empower you to perform better. And even like, let's say now in this, if you are a, let's say, person who are not really engaged in any other professions as such, but is still day-to-day work, like if you want to manage your day-to-day work in the proper way, that in that case even this sort of program should be helpful, right? Now we have to, we all are moving with this digital transformations. We should be able to get our work done. It's just you can see it's a very basic pursuit being enough. But if you know, then you can think little more, and with your knowledge, you can see what else you can do. Then you can contribute in a certain places as well, not directly related to your job, but then you may be able to contribute with your ideas, with your work. Promoting digital dexterity. Raise your hand those who have heard about this term, digital dexterity. These programs will help if you are like promoting digital dexterity. Any one of you know what is digital dexterity? Okay, there are a couple of questions. Mr. Chanukka, yes. Level 9 means only coursework. Yes, in this master programs, you don't have research component. Yes, level 9 qualifications, master programs through coursework. Yes, you don't have research component. And there is another question in the chat. Can you do MPhil or PhD in IT background? That's what you mean? Yes, it's possible. As I mentioned, we are going to have a separate, definitely PhD and MPhil, like you can register with the supervisor and you can do. That is possible. Is that clear, Mr. Chandra? Okay. Raise your hand those who have heard about this term, digital dexterity. Non I hope now you could have search right now at least, right? Okay, so then Shama, there is a question. What is the difference between MSc program and this? Master of Science and this is Master of Information Technology. And there are things like qualifier and all that. Here this master, as I mentioned, there can be some Master of Science program with the research component, then that will go under level 9, SLQF level 9, some master programs which research component that goes to level 9. This master programs without the research component that goes for SLQF level 9. Yes, definitely. Yes, Miss. I am sure. I'm sorry. I don't know whether Mr. or Miss Pereira is asking whether we can do PhD in Sri Lankan University. Yes, of course you can. Now there are a lot of students are doing local PhDs as well. Yes, we can do a PhD in Sri Lankan University. Even we do have. So in that case, you can register with the supervisor with your interest, and if the supervisor is willing to supervise. With your, I mean, the track record or whatever, and then you can register with the same postgraduate institute, I mean, the faculty of graduate studies, and then you can continue. When you are doing the PhDs, you can do it full time or part time basis. Yeah, so that's possible. Okay, now we were discussing about this digital dexterity. What is this digital dexterity? Okay, with that I will ask, you may be knowing, like we use the term literacy very often in the Sri Lanka. Okay, Mr. Rajita is saying adapting new technologies to our related field to produce better results. Yes, very correct, Mr. Rajita. Digital dexterity is adopting new technologies. Now we should be able to adopt the technology, not just for the sake of adapting, like the things that we are doing, how we can improve it. Adopting new technologies. So then we can sometimes manage with the way of doing right now, but we have to see how we can make things better. Ms. Samantha is asking how many years are there to complete PhD. That depends if you are doing a PhD full time or part time. Based on that, the number of years would be different. If you are doing a full time PhD, it will be minimum like 3 years. It can be extended before. But if you are doing the part time, it will take more than that. Okay, what Mr. Rajita has mentioned is correct. The digital dexterity is we should be able to use the new technologies and see how we can perform better. Now, if you are just users of the technology, I mean existing devices, we are just using it. But we have to see in addition to that, how we can make things better through this technology available. I mean, you will be having this. Let's say AI and maybe big data analytics, maybe IoT, those like technology. When you are learning, you can see how we can make things better with these applications of the technology. So non-IT people may not be able to do that, right? So that through these programs, like you should be able to like promote this digital dexterity. When you learn new things and then you see how it can be applied to your organization to make things better. When it comes to this literacy terms, as I mentioned, generally in the Sri Lankans, we call like in Asia, we have very high literacy rate, 90, very close to 100, that is writing, reading ability. But when it comes to IT literacy, people from IT literacy, that is not digital dexterity, right? Earlier people were thinking of IT literacy. What do you mean by IT literacy? Now, this is digital dexterity and the IT literacy is two different things. IT literacy is like just to like work with the simple IT application. For example, like they should be able to just go and get the money from an ATM machine or small application. They should be able to work. This is just like, okay, they are capable of working with the information technology. So then that is the basic IT literacy. But when it comes to digital dexterity, then our people are looking that. Okay, they want the employees. Sometimes they will be in not in the IT department, for the account department or for the HR department. They want people who are having some sort of like idea about this digital dexterity. They are the one who most the problem. Then if they are having some idea, through this technology we can do something. Sometimes they may not be able to do it by themselves, but if they have understanding, they can propose it. Otherwise they don't know what the technology can do and what sort of problems that they are having. Even the technology experts may not be knowing a exact problem that they are having. So that's why even whatever the field that you are working, if you are having the dexterity, it's really great, and that is a value for the company. Now people, okay, there's a question from, are there differences in acceptance between the research component and without research component? Okay, so in our Master of in Technology degree, you don't have the research component. But there are, as I mentioned, there are some masters with research component and without research component. Acceptance-wise, let's say if you are going to go for a research career, yes. In that case, if you have done something, the master programs with the research component, that will be an advantage. So then, but when it comes to some of the qualification wise, some people, some places, they ask this. So in that case, that doesn't matter for them, like if you are having a master, if it is a research based coursework case. But one thing, like with our experience, when we are having this MSc in MIT, we had Master of Science in Management and Information Technology. Because of the research component, I mean, most of the students complete the modules and with their work life and all that, they won't complete the research component. Because of that reason, they won't be able to get the master qualification. So then that is the other part of it. But if you really, really planning to continue the research career, yes, then it would be good for you to go with the research in Finland that way. But if you are going to get as a qualifications, it will be easy for you to complete the qualification and get the degree. But if you are doing a master degree with the research component, very often we have, well, I know many people, they have grades and all A's, but still they have not complete the research component. Because of that reason, they won't be able to get the title, the qualifications, the master. Okay, you're asking, both are in SLQF level 9. SLQF level 9 is this, the without research component, SLQF level 9. And the considerable, like sometimes not like just a small, considerable research component is there. And those programs can be categorized under SLQF 10 as well. Okay, I hope I'm answering your question, sir. Okay, now it's clear, right, that you know digital dexterity. So now you will have to think, okay, now when you learn things, new technologies and all that, you will have to see how you can make things better. That's why I told you, like, you will have to have that mindset. Don't just be happy with what we have. At least try to think. You are having emerging technologies, most probably I might be taking it but you need to come up with the ideas, right? That is where you can do some sort of like little research and innovative things in this program. there is a question. Soon after completing this program, can we go to study PhD directly? There is a possibility. Even soon after the bachelor degree, when people can directly go for my PhD, right? So if you have done a bachelor's degree, a 4-year bachelor's degree, soon after that even people can go for higher studies. For example, I mentioned one of our staff member went to USA last week, and she has completed the bachelor's degree, and then she got a Fulbright scholarship and she went for PhD. Can we do a PhD from foreign universities by locating in Sri Lanka? Okay, good question, but with the current situation, yes. And then other thing is, even though the situations get back to normal, there are split PhDs. I know whether you have heard split in the sense both places. Let's say now you may have registered at the University of Colombo, or you may have registered in the University of, let's say, Monash in Australia. Then you may have registered in one university. Your degree will be offered from one university. Then you will be having supervisors in both places. You will be working like split, like maybe 6 months there and 6 months here. That is kind of a split. And then sometimes I know even you can get the degree in Sri Lankan universities, and sometimes you can have the supervisor in the foreign university as well. There are cases like that. Your question is in the other way. You want to get the qualification from the foreign university by locating in Sri Lanka. With the current setup, yes, I can remember at our staff introduction, Mr. Janaka and Ms. Mahikala Niranga. I think Ms. Mahikala Niranga is working almost close to 1 year now. She has got the placement in Swinburne University in Australia for the PhD. She has been here right now, like in the virtual mode. I think more than 6 months, as I can remember, maybe little close. Definitely, she has to almost a year according to the current situation. And even now the Australia borders are closed, they can't go. And the other person, Mr. Janaka, has got the placement in UK and he's working from here right now. What are the qualifications needed to apply to? Simply the qualification, if you are having a basic degree and good track records. I mean the good track records in the sense somebody should be willing to supervise you. For that purpose, you need to have some sort of research experience. It doesn't matter like not just the degree program research, but if you have written some paper, I mean the research paper articles and published, so they give more weight for that. So then through that will be the criteria. Otherwise, like if you are having a degree with the class, and then having a master would be added advantage, and then your track records, like doing some research publication. Yeah, that is okay. Yeah. For others, like I have been just answering for the questions that these people have put in the chat. Huh? I hope this will be commonly useful for all of you. And then through these programs which enable you for digital transformation. Again, now digital dexterity is something, and the digital transformation, we know like most of the work now we are just trying to transfer with this pandemic. Most of the things have been transferred to digital form. We never thought all these classes, exams and everything now in the virtual form, right? Now even without the pandemic even, there are certain things that we can do in the virtual form. And when it comes to the business even, a lot of things are taking place in online mode. But we'll discuss more when it comes to digital transformation. You may be knowing some other terms related to this. People talk about this digitization, digitalization, there are small differences, and digital innovation. when it comes to digital innovation, it's not like the invention, eh? Like it's not finding a cure for cancer. Not completely new, but what we are trying to digital innovation, do a digital innovation. That means you're just trying to do something in an innovative way. So it may not be completely new. It's not find a cure for cancer or a cure for COVID-19. But existing knowledge, we are using the existing knowledge to do something in a more innovative way. Same at the that even you can do with digital dexterity. You are using the emerging technologies to give a good solution. But technology is there, but you are just trying to see how this technology can be used to make things better. So in your programs right now, we have a quick look at your curriculum. I'm taking time, right? Yeah. Now only I look at the clock. Okay. So then I look at the when you look at the MIT curriculum, you can see you have here 9 modules. Some modules you are familiar with this credit value, right? Some modules are 3 credits, and there are a couple of modules which are 2 credits, right? You can see out of this 9 modules. You have 2 credits modules, and the other 7 modules are 3 credits. I hope you all have some understanding about the credit value. Do you want me to explain?
No, ma'am.
Yeah. I'll get it. Then we have like this is not the total curriculum. I have some other subjects in the next slide. this is not the whole subject. I have listed only 9 subjects in this slide, but we have some other subjects. I don't think this is the total curriculum. Huh? Here, this just to indicate, these we'll be completing those modules first. Hmm? So these 9 modules, you can see 7 3 credit module. Okay, let me explain what is this credit value. Right? Somebody mentions. The credit value indicate the workload that you have to do in this module. For example, now the last digit, when it comes to subject code, the last digit indicates the credit value. You can see all these modules, the last digit indicate the credit value. General definitions, and the credit, 1 credit is equal to 15 contact hours. 1 credit, if you are learning 1 credit module, that means you will be having 15 contact hours with the person who is doing. And but you are supposed to altogether spend 50 notional hours. You will have to do some assignments and all that. You are supposed to spend 50 hours altogether for 1 credit. If it is 2 credit, you are supposed to spend 15 to 2, that means you are supposed to spend 100 notional hours. But the direct contact hours should be 15 into 2. Hmm? But the 15 direct contact hours for 1 credit, if it is 2 credit, double of that, right? 30 contact hours. Then if it is 3 credits, then the direct contact hours would be 15 into 3, that means 45. That means those modules you will be having 45 contact hours with your lecturer. But that doesn't mean that 45 is enough. But if the weightage is, as I mentioned, if the 1 credit module, you are supposed to spend 50 hours all together doing assignments and some other homework and all that. If it is a 3 credit module, you are supposed to work 50 into 3. That means 150 hours you need to work. Is that clear about the credit value? Through that, you need to know like how much effort you need to put into this particular module. For example, these 2 modules which are 2 credits, you need compare to that less number of hours, but then these modules you may have to spend little hours. And the other things, when you are going to calculate the GPA in the sense somewhat similar to what you call the average, general average, the class average, or your marks average. So then the 3 credits module more than the 2 credit module. You will be getting A for both, but if you have got A for 3 credit module, then that carries more weight for your final grade point average. Okay, is that clear about the credit value? Credit? Okay, remember this 9 modules, this 9 module, all these 9 modules are compulsory, which carries 25 credits, but for this MIT programs, you need to complete 32 credits. So then in the next slide, I have the other modules, but before that, is that clear about the credit value? Are you clear about the credit? Like we use the term credit, okay, this subject is 3 credit, this subject is 2 credit. You don't have any other numbers in this program. All your subjects are either 3 credits or 2 credits. That gives some indication to you the effort that you need to put in. And at the same time, if you are thinking of getting a distinction pass or the merit passes, so that for your GPA, even you have to think of, not just thinking, but anyway, it's good to have get a good grades, and then that will reflect your average marks. So then you need to have some understanding about it. Okay, hope it is clear now. Okay, now before moving to the next slide, now these are the first, I think, I will let you know how we are going to deliver the module. These 9 modules are compulsory. I have listed first 3 modules. We will be starting with these first 3 modules from next week. We will start delivering these first 3 modules in next week. Computer systems, programming concepts, database concept. All these modules are compulsory. That means whether you like it or not, you will have to do it. Like compulsory. Oh, sorry. This C indicate compulsory. I forgot to mention. This C indicate compulsory. But if you have put O, that indicate optional. That means you have the choice, right? If you like, you can select. If not, you don't want to select, right? I mean, you can select something else, but you have to complete the requirement to get the degree. This number of credits you need to complete, right? As I mentioned, you need to complete 30. I'll mention those two in the criteria, but that relevant number of credits you need to complete. But here, all the compulsory module anyway, you will have to do. So all these 3 modules are compulsory. So we will be offering these 3 modules, which gives you the foundation for the rest of the modules as well. So that's the reason that we have put those modules at the beginning or at the very early stage of your program. So then we will let you know. I'll have the schedule for these 3 modules since we are going to start it from next week. And then after that, we'll be starting kind of these 3 modules or sometimes with the 2 credits, one we'll see with the current situations, how are we going to go. Exactly this, the delivery process with these 3 according to the order given may not happen. As I showed you in the pictures, IoT. We have a lot of tools kits at the department. We would prefer to people to come to the department to do this thing. But we'll see in the pandemic, if we can't, this current situation, if we can't do it, we'll have to find the alternative mechanism. Now, we mentioned, I told you as well, with this, we'll have to ready to learn and we need to. See how we can work in this with this uncertainties as well. So we'll have to find different ways, alternative ways to do things. So then you have seen the modules that you have in this program. These are the first 9 modules: computer system, programming concept, database concept, data communications and computer network, web and multimedia technologies, software engineering, internet of things, intelligent systems, MIS. All these modules are compulsory. That means whether you like it or not, you'll have to do this. In addition to that, we have another 4 modules. You have advanced programming, you have machine learning, you have big data analytics, you have seminar on emerging technologies. Now you can see these 4 modules, the status is different. Earlier I have put CCC. Now these modules these first three modules are optional. But why I have put these modules at the end, these are little advanced, that the basic fundamental knowledge that you are getting from the other modules would be helpful. We will be offering these modules towards end of this degree program. And this seminar module is compulsory. This is compulsory, that is where you can use your innovative thinking and all that. Even in the other modules you can use, you will be having some coursework assignments, but here again this modules you will have to do. That is altogether how many credits? Now how many compulsory credits you have?
28.
How many?
28.
25 was there in the previous slide, 9 subjects. Here even this seminar modules is also compulsory. Now all together now you will be, you have 25 plus 3, that means 28 compulsory credits. Definitely all of you will be doing those 10 modules. Whether you like it or not, if you have registered for this group, those 10 modules. And then there is a requirement, candidates are expected to obtain a minimum of 32 credits. But 28 credits are not enough for you to get the Master of Information Technology. So you need to get 4 more credits, right? Okay, 4 more credits. If you are doing these 2, you will be getting 5. If you are doing these 2, you will be getting 5. If you are doing these 2, you will be getting 6. If you are doing all these 3, you will be getting another 8. That doesn't matter. So then somehow or the other, you will do another 2 modules. But in future, we will see, we are trying to put some other modules to this basket, optional basket. In that case, you may be having some other combination as well. Right now, these are the 3 modules which are there in this, this basket. So to fulfill the requirements, you need to do another 2 modules to get the 4 credits. Né? So you can't get exactly 4 credits because 1 is 3, 1 is 2, right? If there was 2 credit modules, you could have got exactly 4, but it doesn't matter, right? You can do more. Only thing is, if you have to do more, like when we are calculating the average, all the modules will be considered and the average will be taken from. In this case, we will be offering all these modules. If you like, you can do all 3, and if you like, you can do 2 of these 3. Okay, I hope now you have some idea about the the modules that you are going to learn in this program. And then definitely there are 10 modules, compulsory modules, you will have to do it. And then that is not enough for you to get the degree, you need to have 32 credits. Now you know the credits value, how we can measure the last digits of the subject code. Then in addition to that, you need to have 4 more credits. Only you are getting 28 credits from the compulsory modules. So then for that, you will have to do another 2 modules. Minimum, all together, all of you have to do at least 12 modules. According to the current this thing, you will have to do 12 modules. Or if you want, you can do 13 modules as well. Okay? Is that clear? Considering the possibility of adding few more modules in future, like with the current trends and all that, we might add more modules for this basket. Then of course you will have your, you will have a big choice. I mean, now your choice, you have a limited choice, right? Right now, out of 3, you will have to select 2. If you want, you can do all 3, but if you put more to the basket, you will have be having a good selection there. Okay, so then as I mentioned, we will be starting your lectures from next week, which is 21st August 2021. One thing I forgot to mention, this Master of Information Technology, which is level 9 according to SLQF, as we mentioned earlier. But generally those master programs are 1 year. But we might take, like we are like always trying to follow the timetable, and we will take 1.5 years to deliver the module. deliver the content. The reason is we are taking lectures only on Saturday. So we are keeping Sunday free. Because of that reason, for us to offer those modules, it takes more than a year. Theoretically, it is a 1 year master program, but to complete it, it takes a little more than a year. Maybe like less than 1.5, but all together with the results, compilations and all that, we just try to compile everything and finish within that time period, right? So now you can see when you are taking lectures only on Saturday, we can't, maximum we can have only 3 lectures per week. So we know all of you are working people and it's better for you people to have 1 day off. That's why we have kept Sunday off. Even when you are having lectures physically, even we are planning to keep the Sunday off and have the lectures on Saturday. We will be starting the programs in the virtual mode starting from this 21st. As I mentioned, we will be starting with these 3 modules. All these 3 modules are 3 credits, as we have seen in the previous slide. Computer systems, programming concepts, and the database concepts. Computer system module will be delivered by Dr. Vijay Sivarthana. I hope you can remember him. He was there at the inauguration ceremony today. And the programming concept will be delivered by Dr. Chaturraj Pasha. I know all of you may be knowing him and you have already contacted him. He will be doing this programming concept module. And database concept will be done by myself. So those are the 3 modules that you will be learning from next week. Here, this is the tentative schedule for this first semester or the first part. Here you can see we will be each week, we have put here the dates, the 21st, 28th, likewise, we will be starting in August 21st. And this is how the sessions are planned. You will be having the computer systems in the morning, 3-hour session, 8 to 11. And then you will be having programming concepts, 11:30 to 2:30, 3 hours. And then you will be having the next module, database concept, 3:15 to 6:15. So you are having 3 sessions on Saturday. You are having a small break in between, and sometimes like if there are any changes happening the order of the subject, we will let you know, but this is the general schedule, like computer systems and the programming concept and the database concepts. And when you look at this schedule, as I mentioned about the credit value and how much time that we need to spend based on the credit value, all these modules are 3 credit modules. That means we roughly used to have, if it is 1 credit, I told you, contact hours would be 15. And if it is a 3 credit modules, 15 into 3, normally we used to have 15 contact direct contact hours. So that's why we have scheduled these for 15 weeks. 3 hour each, you will be getting 45 direct contact hours. But in addition to that, you people are supposed to another 105 hours. You'll be getting assignments and all that. You need to spend another 105 hours. And then, okay, we will complete all these 3 modules with 15 weeks. That means, according to this plan, end of November, we will be able to complete those. And then we will be having the study group for 2 weeks. And then we will have the exam, most probably your exam on in December for these 3 modules. That's how we finish. Okay, we deliver 3 modules and then we give 1 week or 2 weeks study leave and conduct the exams and then start the next 3 modules. That is the plan that we have. Let me check a couple of some chat messages are there. Okay, good questions. AP, I don't know the name. Like there is a question from AP. how will be the evaluation criteria? Is it continuous assessment or final exam? But if you look at our curriculum, our assessment criteria indicate the continuous assessment plus final examination. But the percentage for the continuous assessment and final examinations, individual lecturers will let you know, like, okay, what percentage will be taken for, like, continuous assessment may consist of different component, multiple component. So then they will let you know, like, the percentage for each component. But yes, we do have some concern about the final exam, right? I mean, we used to have final exam, physical exams earlier. Now, a bit of a concern is there when you are going to have the virtual examination. You know, like, it's really hard. Like, people conduct virtual final examinations, but there are possibilities, even though we have used all these mechanisms to monitor, but still there are rules to certain things. Anyway, we will let you know exact criteria for each module, but in that case, we will try to have some Viva component in it. Now, otherwise, it's not fair. Sometimes, if you're going to have the virtual examinations with the, we will be having a kind of in-class test kind of things in the virtual online mode, but we are not going to have one component which carries a major percentage without having a Viva. Because we want to make sure whether the students reflect the knowledge. There are some other questions. In physical classes, we will have lectures until 6:50. Physical classes. In the physical setup, we will see how we can do, whether if you people are comfortable, whether we can go for one evening. But then we will discuss and decide the time when it comes to physical classes. I know some of you may be traveling from Maunia and all that, and then considering what would be the most convenient way for all of you, I think that in that case, we'll have to see, like, the best interest for the group. We will come up with the plan. Can we complete the MIT by end of next year, December?
Boy.
Now we are in
August. How about you? PK kinak tiyan kyan PR din yung karan nito.
Exact plan, as I mentioned, roughly it might take 1.5 years. Close to December, like it might be January, February. I'm not very sure whether we will be able to. You can understand, like, when you are going to deliver 3 modules in this way, yes, we are without, like, I will be having much break, we are starting and all that, but still, if we are taking only one day per week, it's hard for us to finish it early, because the 3, 3, 3, so we'll have to have, like, now we are, you notice we have 13 subjects, right? If you are going to go for, like, 15 weeks, 3 modules, 15 weeks is roughly around, how many months? If you consider the 4 into 3, like 3.5, 4 months, right? So then we'll have to go 4 months into, like, 4 into 4, like 16. With your study leave and all that, roughly takes 1.5 years. Okay, so then there is another question. When you need to select the optional module, if you don't want to select it now itself, but you have time, like we will be offering this compulsory module first, the first 9 modules. After that, when it comes to the last semester, last part of the your master programs, we will be delivering those modules. At that time, you can select those optional modules. Can we get the lectures recorded? Yes, you can get the lectures recorded. Yes, the recording is possible. We will be putting the record, but remember, now we are having this real-time classes. The reason that we are having the real-time classes, we need to have interaction. So then if you all are thinking, okay, we can have the recording, and if you are not coming for classes, then of course we also don't want to have the class, you recording and put it, and you can listen it anytime. Then you are not getting the chance to interact in the class and ask questions and clarify doubts then and there. So now we are having this, we are conducting these real-time classes without just putting the recording, and for you to give that benefit. So make use of that benefit. Then even though the recording are there, you need to attend for classes and interact. Then you can ask questions. As I told you, like you can have more interactive session. Now we don't want to like have that one person talking, but you all are professionals. Some people may be having some experience. As I told you, some of you may have learned things in a different way. You can share. Sometimes it will be correct, and sometimes it may not be not correct or wrong. But you can think whether is that the best way. Are there any other better ways? So we can discuss things, so we can make it more interactive. There's another question. Are we using CAL as the LMS? Yes, we have LMS, learning management system, for our postgraduate, so we'll be using that. Exam will be conducted by online, that's what I told you. Like we will let you know about the examination process. We will definitely will be having some continuous assessment, in-class test online, which carries maybe 20-30% your relevant lecturers will let you know about the percentage. But the final examination or the whole process, if you are going to have those components, we will be having Viva. I mean, you know what is Viva, right? That means just assess your knowledge. Otherwise, if you are conducting the online exams, and even though we monitor, if you are getting the help from, if somebody is getting the help from somebody or somewhere and doing it and getting a grade which does not reflect the knowledge, therefore it's not good for you, it's not good for the program. Therefore, in that case, we will have some sort of a Viva to assess your knowledge. Not just, we are not going mainly only on the online mode, right? We will be having a small component, as I mentioned, in class test online mode, which carries the little percentage, yes, we will be having. The final exam per se, still we have not decided to go for online, but we'll let you know, like as you mentioned, in the current situation, nothing is certain, but since we are not in a position to get new people to the university, we'll have to find alternative mechanism. Otherwise, it might take time for you to graduate. Okay, I will explain to you. Like, okay, then there's a question. What is the criteria to complete to get the master's degree? What is the GPA? Minimum GPA. I'll get back to that in the next slide. What is the minimum GPA required to get the degree? Yes, I'll let you know. Okay. Yes. Thanks for those questions. I will address in the next slide. Okay. This is the plan for the first part of the programs, which consists of these three modules, and. Here, when it comes to the grading, you know, you are familiar with these grades A, B, C. When it comes to A, we have A plus, A minus as well. Same for B plus, B minus. In between A, we have A plus, B minus. Same in between B, B plus, B minus. All that are there. As I mentioned, normally we have the examinations at the end of each round. You are required to get B minus to pass the module, no? Not like undergraduates, right? Undergraduate courses, you know, like if you have got C and above, that will be considered as pass. But in the postgraduate module, you have passed the module, then you need to get the minimum B minus. So now, for each grade, here you can see the grade value, right? If you have A plus, for one credit, that means you are getting 4 as value. So then if you are having A the same, if you are having A minus 3.7, if you are having B plus 3.3, if you are having B 3, if you are having B minus 2.7, you know this is the pass level for the, what you call this, for this master's program, or all postgraduate, not only for this master. So to pass the module, you need to get minimum B minus. But if you don't think of getting those grades, no way, right? Don't think of getting those grades. You all are supposed to get A's, worst case, B minus. Hmm? So all of your transcript should have those grades. And try to go for A's, but when it fair, like the minimum grade that you can go for, to B minus, which carries the grade point value is 2.7. Hmm? So now you can see, to get the degree, your GPA should be above this. Hmm? Because this is the pass mark for all the modules. Yes, we are using, I am recording the session, right? Can get the recording, yeah. And even the slides I can provide you. You are asking about the final thesis, SSAA. You don't have, since I told you this is, you don't have a research component, then you don't have a final thesis. But each module, there will be some certain assignment. But in addition to that, the seminar module, emerging technologies, you will have to do a
recording
kind of innovative project. And for that, you need to submit the report, right? The kind of dissertation. It's not the research dissertation, but some innovative ideas. Our learning management systems, we have a computer-aided, we call it the CAL, computer-aided learning management systems. It's somewhat similar to Moodle, but now we have a separate one for graduate, but don't worry, we will share those information, so that we will be using a learning management system.
Madam, recording stopped.
Recording stopped? Oh my god, when? It has been stopped? Sorry. It stop right now?
Yes, madam. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I don't know. By mistake, I will have clicked something there.
Recording in progress.
Good, good. You are like vigilant and attention to detail is there. No, you notice right at the correct time. Okay, good. Oh my god, I think it has been stopped, not by clicking anything. My space is full here, like, you know, that's the reason. Oh my god. Do you want me to clear? Okay, this part there won't be much next, so then shall we continue? Anyway, when you are moving forward, even you can ask those things. Shall I clear some space, then do you want me to record the rest of the part as well? You prefer, right? Give me 2 minutes then.
Thank you.
Recording stopped.
Okay, I think now it will be okay. Sorry for the interruption. You want me to record? So I can explain this thing. I just want to search it and delete. That's the reason it takes time. Answer. I need to create up to 1 GB. okay, I think I'm just mentioning about the receipt. I won't expect any one of you to do the receipt, right? But there can be some medical cases, but the receipt, we don't want to think of the receipt, right? We all can do it at the first time. But for your information, in case, I'll just put it here. There is a, as you mentioned, if you have got some grade less than B minus, then you can receipt and try to increase your grade. But in that case, the maximum that you can get is B minus. Even though you have got 70 marks, if it is a receipt, maximum you can get B minus. So therefore, at the first instance, just put little effort and try to get good grade. The worst case, you may get B minus, but don't think of going beyond that. If you are doing the receipt, then in that case, the maximum you can get B minus. The maximum number of attempts allowed to receipt is any course is 3. This is just the information, but I won't expect any one of you to go for this number of times, but just only one sitting, you should be able to get a better grade. As you mentioned, we are ready to learn now, like our mindset is there, right? In that case, you all have passed, got the degree level or equivalent qualifications. That means it's not a big thing, right? You know, you can remember A-level. A-level was very competitive, only very limited number of students are getting selected to universities. But when it comes to universities, that competition is not there, right? That's, if you have done, like, you can pass. If you have performed well, you can get a good grade and good classification, good class as well. But when it comes to masters, like, you can see it's, the challenge is getting, like, reduced. If you have done, like, A-level as well, and if you have done degree or equivalent qualifications, doing this master degree is not a challenge. But if you are new to the field, like, yes, you may have to put little effort at the beginning, but since you people are intelligent enough, you can do it, right? So don't think of like doing receipt. This is just the information in case. I think just to discourage you people to do repeat, I think we can increase the price as well, right? The repeat examination fee, in addition to what you have already paid, for the repeat examination, you have to pay additional. But I think to discourage, they can increase more, right? At least then you get the motivation, right? Okay, I have to spend like another, like, let's say, big amount. Then through that, you will get discouraged to do the repeat. So that means you will get encouraged to pass at the first instance. So then you are supposed to complete the degree within the one and a half years. But then if you are taking additional time, annual extension fee will be there. That means we expect all of you, like, okay, our batch size is whatever the size, you all should be able to get the degree within that time period, right? Here is, okay, to get the degree at the end of completing all these required qualifications, that means completing minimum 32 credits, then you are eligible to get the degree. So here you can see the criteria. Here is the degree awarding criteria to pass. To get the degree with the pass, what you need to do is, candidate is eligible to get the MIT, Master of Information Technology degree, if he or she obtained B minus or better in course units aggregating to a minimum 32. We mentioned, like, you will end up with 33, right? Very often, like, based on the credit values, or you may end up with 36. So you can't do 31, the minimum. So then according to the current subject combinations, you may end up with completing 33 credits or 36 credits. Then grades aggregating minimum 32 credits inclusive of all compulsory course, all compulsory course, you will have to have B minus or better. So then in that case, even though you have got A's and A's and all that, but your average will be 2.7, but if you are having a lower grade for compulsory module, you have to do it again. So therefore, obtain grades B minus or better in course units aggregating to a minimum 32 credit inclusive all compulsory. Here the all compulsory is there, you notice like you have more compulsory modules, right? 28 credits are compulsory, so then it is a must for you to get the B minus or better for all 28. But for one optional module, if you are having a lower grade, that will not restrict you to get the degree. Achieve minimum 2.7, right? Minimum 2.7, that means B minus average, and complete the relevant requirement within the period of 3 academic years. The maximum you can go for 3 academic years. So this is just to pass the degree, but if you, I think you can get a degree with the merit pass or distinction pass. To get the merit pass or distinction pass, this is the criteria. Candidate shall be awarded to a merit pass provided he or she obtain grades of B plus or better in all course units aggregate into a minimum of 32, again inclusive all compulsory. That means all compulsory modules you should get B plus or better. If you are having one B minus, then you are not qualified to get this. Then achieve the minimum GPA 3.7. Minimum GPA you need to get 3.7. And obtain grades of A or better in course units aggregating to at least 50% of the total credit for the course unit considered for the awarding in MIT. Let's say then out of 32, if you have done 32, like 50%, like at least 16, you need to have A or better, A or A plus. Let's say if you are having more A minuses, you may end up with having 3.7. Let's say if you are having all A minuses, you will get this criteria. I think that you will fulfill this criteria, you will fulfill this criteria, but you may not fulfill this criteria. So then you will have to fulfill like 1, 2, 3, and here is a complete the relevant requirement in the first category. So if you have done the second attempt, you are not qualified to get the merit pass. And then the other one is the distinction pass. Candidate shall be awarded distinction again. Obtains grades A or better in course units aggregating to a 32, minimum 32, inclusive all compulsory. That means you need to get A's for all modules. And you need to get the GPA 4, like for that you need to get the A's for all modules. Then if you have got A's for all the modules, you can get the distinction pass. If you are getting fulfilling this criteria, you can get the merit pass. But if you have not fulfilled those criteria, and if you have fulfilled 2.7 average with the B minus and above for all, then you can get the degree. Is that clear? Somebody asked it earlier as well. Hope it's clear, right? Then once you complete everything, you know, as same as your undergraduates, you need to apply for the degree. Candidate should apply for the award of Master of Information Technology degree upon completion of the suitable requirement. That's okay. Then anyway, it's too early for you to think about it. Once you complete, you need to request the degree. You need to fill the form and request. On the completions of MIT, a candidate is entitled to an official transcript, right? So even if everything is finalized, you are entitled to get the official transcript in the respective course unit after the confirmations of the result by the university center. You may not, sometimes even, you know, in the Sri Lanka university system, it might take some time for you to have the final certificate, like the convocations and all might take little time for the administrative work. But once you complete the requirements and if your result class has been approved by the Senate, you can get the transcript. So anyway, we are trying our best to do like follow our schedule and finish the program as we have promised. We need your support as well. We need your support. The thing is, now we have mentioned we will conduct 3 modules and give 1 or 2 weeks study leave and then the exam. But then we have to see the continuous assessment. We will let you know. But sometimes you are telling, okay, can we have another week and can we have a break before starting the next semester? That all will we can do. But what will happen eventually? Like if you are going to do it, like your programs will take complete. Okay, so then in addition to the earlier I mentioned, you people should ready to learn now little things that the basic responsibilities. I know all of you are responsible citizen, you know general responsibilities, but I'm just reminding here some key responsibilities. Learning is your responsibility, right? You have and then we will provide, we will facilitate and we create the environment for you to learn. But you know, it's not like sport. The learning is your responsibility. So since the medium of instructions is English, English language proficiency is also important. You need to have a dream. I mean, then only it helps you to like work towards that. As I mentioned, you should be curious and you should work for your aims and objectives. Then you will be more energetic and like self-driven person, and you will work really hard and learn the culture, network, respect and get respect for you. Here that when you are having when you are with us at the DIM family, yeah, you can learn the culture. Unfortunately, in this virtual environment, it may not be very easy for you to learn. And the network, like it's really important in the master programs, networking with other professionals and other colleagues and maybe faculty. Then network with people, that is also important. Like it's good for you to know many people, and through that you can learn in addition to the things, individual modules. And respect and get respect, right? That is, as a good citizen, we should give respect, and then based on that, we might get the necessary respect as well. There is a question, do you give class passes for MIT? You are asking about the first class, second class? Anjali, Ms. Anjali, you are asking about the same as undergraduate, the first class, second class. There is a question, it says, do you give class passes? Is that you mean, Ms. Anjali? Okay, no, like you have that distinction and merit and the pass. These are the categories. Undergraduates, you know, like in the degrees, you have first class, second upper, second lower, third class, sometimes some places, but otherwise the normal pass. But in this master programs, we have distinction, merit passes and the pass. So then there is no another category called like first class, second class, no. Rajmohan, I'm not clear what you're asking. I think past paper class. What do you mean by? Can you elaborate your questions, Rajmohan? Then, as part of your responsibilities, you need to have the right attitudes, you know, like in, as professionals, you know, right, our attitudes matters, né? The way we take things, that is very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so what there's a question, so before the exam, whether we are discussing past papers, yeah, we will be having some sort of like, okay, you can request and arrange revision classes or some discussions where we can collect the past papers, e-books. Of course, sometimes your relevant lecturers will recommend you and they will provide the e-book. There's a question, if you want, can we get a certificate before completing 2 years? It may not take 2 years, as I told earlier, but yes, there will be option for you to get the postgraduate diploma, not the master's, without doing the last part. So that option would be there. Yes, there will be a connotation, same as for any other degree and the master's. Yes, there will be a connotation for the MIT as well, once you complete. Currently, I don't know how it will be. Okay, so I find that case you cannot get much time to engage with extracurricular activities, but if possible, we would like to connect you with our undergraduates and the relevant activities. Possible if you are, I know some of you are very much busy with your family commitments and the professional commitments, but if you have some time, so you can get connected with some other activities and you can use the university resources available. And then, most importantly, you need to have your own opinion. As postgraduate students, you need to have your own opinion and you have already some knowledge, so then you should be sensible. You don't want to accept things if somebody else is telling, but you can think and use your analytical skills, knowledge, and you can explore it more, and then open opinion. I appreciate if you can mute your So in addition to that, you need to develop, I know you all you have already developed your soft skills, but then we will again use this as the opportunity to develop your other skills as well. When you are having class discussions and all that, we can use those things as opportunities to develop other skills as well. And then always just try to become the best you can be. Don't like just do like the for the sake of doing, just put your maximum effort and try to become the best you can be, whatever you do. So always you should try to exceed the standards which has been set by the other people. So then always just try to get the distinction pass. I mean, like the getting 4 as the average. Don't think of, you know, one is going to get it. No, nothing like that. Then you can exceed those and you can get it. Work for that. Hard work, as I mentioned, so you need to have a good time management and all that. And be smart and enjoy yourself, but be responsible as well. So this is your responsibilities. In addition to that, I have this included here. When you are coming to the physical environment, as I showed you some pictures, you can see some of the furniture in the department. So we have to think of all those furnitures and other resources belongs to us, since you are part of us. Then when you are using those resources, we have to be mindful. Same as when you are like how you keep your own stuff, not let other outside parties to come in and use those things, and all that general things you need to apply. And generally, if you are going to be in the physical classroom, you are not supposed to use the mobile phones. And even in the Zoom classes, even I appreciate if you can keep your mics muted, and but when you want to interact, then you can unmute and interact. Yeah, if you can be more interactive, that will be more, I think, enjoyable, and your learning even will be high. So when you are using the physical resources, when you are using the libraries, labs and all that, we have to be mindful of the resources, electricity and all that. When you are moving a place, we are supposed to switch off the light if no one is using, and these are general things. As I mentioned, our furnitures and all that, we have to use mindfully. We should not fight anything, or we have to use them thinking that there are many more students should use them in future, and they also should feel it's like brand new condition. As I told you, like 20 years old, stuff still looks new. And be punctual and responsible and all that are other attributes that we expect, and I'm sure you all are having it, but we will try to develop them through this program. When the lecture is over, if you are using the physical this thing, but even when you are having these virtual classes, even try to come to the class on time. But if there is any delay from our side, even we also should try to be punctual. And then if there is anything, we need to respect other people's time, we need to communicate. As I mentioned, so we'll have to think of these other resources and use them mindfully. And the equipment we care, thinking they all belongs to us, and then it's ours. Like now you will be part of our family, so then when you are using it, we will have to use it care. Okay, so then, yeah, once again, I'll congratulate all of you, like now with this pandemic situations, with all the challenges that you have done, like you have put like one more step to your journey. The congratulations for this, you did it, and then now the next part is you need to do the program well. Then I wish you all the very best for that. I'm sure you can do it. As I told you, like it's just nothing, but only thing is you need to put little effort and organize your work, since you are working and your family life and all that. So we are aware of all that. That's why we have kept. So then you can arrange everything successfully. Anything else that you want to know from me, you can ask. And the other things for us to like communicate with you people easily, I would request you to appoint one person as a batch representative. So that will be easy for us to communicate with the batch, because the responsibility of the batch representative, discuss with the batch, and whatever the concerns batch representative can forward to us. And you can have the WhatsApp group, then that will be easy for you people to communicate. Okay, so already you have created the WhatsApp group, right? It says there is a WhatsApp group to communication someone has created, okay? Definitely will provide you the common platform LMS thing, but in addition to that, like since your mobile phone is with you all the time, and then WhatsApp and all that, it will be easy for you to like achieve somebody. Some people may not be checking the LMS quite often, but then it's better on top of that for you to have those WhatsApp group. Okay, so then okay, already there is a WhatsApp group created. I think somebody has the has shared. Miss Samantha has shared it. All of you can join that. And as I told you, I sometimes you may need little time to appoint one person. Isn't it? You can discuss with the WhatsApp group and appoint one person as the best. And then are there any other questions? Okay, there was one thing I saw somewhere. After getting postgraduate certificate, can we follow complete course? You are asking about the postgraduate diploma? Is that you mean? There is a if you want, you can get the exit after completing 25 credit, and you can get the postgraduate diploma, but you may not be able to get two qualification. So then if you have then you'll have to decide whether you want to go for a master degree or you want to get the exit from there. Then if you get the exit in the later date, like it's a kind of a different process, but then it's better for you to first decide whether you want to get the master degree or whether you are in a hurry. Let's say sometimes all of a sudden you may need to, otherwise it's just doing another two modules, getting a master degree would be better, né? Otherwise but let's say if you are in a hurry to like migrate or whatever, in that case it is good to get something like some qualifications or that kind of cases, it would be okay for you to go for that option. Okay, so then you are a student, yes, I know some of you are still not formally registered and all that. That of course I'll have to check and we'll see. Anyway, now we can communicate, your emails are there. So we will see how we can get this process done, getting this email address and all that. First, you need to complete your registration. Even for the postgraduate, the minimum GPA would be the same, B minus level. That means 2.7 GPA would be required. How many students in this group? I'm also not very sure for that right now. I can see we have 88 participants, but all of them may not have formally registered yet, but we'll have to see it by next week. I think we may be able to get to know exact number. Maybe I'm not very sure about the exact number, whether all of you are going to continue. I appreciate if you can let us know whether you have taken the decision, then we know how many students are going to continue with us. Yeah, now we can see altogether there are 989 or that this thing. Okay, do you have any questions, any clarification? No, you can talk, right? Not only the chat, right? How about the student IDs? Yes, student IDs even, you need to, some of you, you need to complete the formal registration process. Okay, there is a message. I think all of you can see the message. The WhatsApp link is not directing. Can we know the contact number of the person who created the group? So the person who created the WhatsApp group, that person can share the contact number to the whole group. Okay, thanks, Manoj. Yeah. So, anything else that you want to know? Like, you can talk, right? Not only the chat message. Anything else? If you don't have anything, we can wind up the session. We will be meeting next week, as I mentioned, the 21st Saturday, you will be having 3 sessions. My session will be in the evening, but before that you will be having another 2 sessions. We will share the link with you until we might take little time to get the student numbers and the other things arranged. But anyway, we will use the, we'll communicate the necessary information via email. Okay, no more questions. Any clarifications? Okay, the Mr. Manoj has shared the new link. The payment plan. I think already. I think the Dr. Chatra would have explained to you people. Yes, you can register, and before the next exam, if you can make the first installment, you need to make the first installment, otherwise you won't be able to admission, right? So therefore, just try to make the installment, but if you have any special cases, but still, I think you will have to make the payment. Okay, then if you don't want to see, it seems that no further questions. Okay, I'm really sorry about the interruptions happened in the middle of the discussion, because I think my hard disk is full and I have not deleted most of the things. That is again my bad management. Yeah, that is also a lesson, right? So it took some time for me to like delete some stuff. I'm really sorry about that interruptions. Okay then. Have a great day and stay safe. I know like this time period is not good time period. Stay safe. I think many staff members and many members in the is also got affected. So stay safe and we will meet. Okay, all the very best.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.